Right everyone, so we have started recording. So the purpose of this lecture is, you know, to give you a little bit basics on Selenium IDE. Now I have prepared material here that I'm going to provide you an overview on. Now please let me know if you have any question. So if you take a look at here in this document that I have for you, let me resume recording. So now, what is Selenium? Can everyone hear me and see my screen? Okay. Selenium is an open source automated testing suite for web applications across different browsers and platforms. It is quite similar to QTP UFT, but Selenium focuses on automating web-based applications. Right, so from the definition you can see Selenium is an open source automated testing suite. Right, open source automated testing suite. What does this mean? Open source means companies doesn't need to pay for it, and anyone can take Selenium's code and they can build it, they can improve it. That is what is open source. It is not a licensed vendor automation testing tool like UFT, right? So UFT, if you want to use it for your business, you have to purchase their license. One license cost nearly $8,000 to $9,000 per year. For a license, it is costly. But Selenium, it is an open source. You do not need to license this tool, and you know any skilled people can improve Selenium. Now, Selenium only automates the web page, right? By UFT, you can automate this Microsoft Word application. You can test this Microsoft Word application. You can test this window by UFT, as well as any browser. But by Selenium, you can only automate browser. You can only automate browser means you can only automate web pages, not the desktop or office applications. Okay, now let me close this, save, and go back there. Okay, now what is this? Okay, now so this is a couple of things to note. This is an open source automated testing suite and only for web application. What does open source means? Open source means you do not need to purchase license for it, and any skilled person can write code to improve the Selenium. Okay, and it works similarly as QTP UFT, but Selenium focuses on only browser based automation, not desktop application, not Windows desktop application. Okay, now the thing is, right, the thing is UFT, Selenium, in Selenium you can use Java, C#, Ruby, Python. The name that I mentioned, Java, Ruby, Python, and C Sharp. These four languages. You can use any of these languages if you know. Right? You can use any of these languages if you know. But with UFT, you can use only VB scripting, which is a scripting language, lightweight, less complex. But with Selenium, you can use four languages: Java, C Sharp, Python, or Ruby. Okay? Now, in my practical work experience, I use Java and Ruby for Selenium coding. Now, what is the catch? So, if Selenium is free, you do not need to, you know, pay $8,000 or $9,000 per year. Why I need to buy QTP or UFT? So much money, $8,000-$9,000, right? Why I need to use QTP where Selenium is free? Right? This is a valid question. Are you going to ask me this question? So if
most of the people they use this one, they will.
Now see this. Selenium is free. UFT is $8,000-$9,000 license cost. Now what is the catch? The catch here, in Selenium you are spending money on labor. You are investing on labor. In UFT, you are resources. In UFT, you do not need that much skilled resources, but in Selenium, if you want to hire a Selenium tester, he will have to have good skill. You will have to pay more. And it is time consuming. Testing, automating in Selenium is time consuming. UFT is less time consuming. And in IT, if you get a job, you will see time is money. The automation that you can do by UFT, it will take higher time for the tester to do it, code it in Selenium. And they are spending money over there. And in UFT, it is less complex, less time consuming. You understand, right? Okay. Now, Selenium, there are four components. Those are associated with Selenium. Selenium IDE, Selenium Remote Control. Remote control is no longer being used. So instead of remote control, they improved it to Selenium WebDriver and then Selenium Grid. So these four components. Out of these four components, Selenium IDE is just for basics testing. It is a prototype tool. And then Selenium Remote Control, it is obsolete. They improved it to Selenium WebDriver. And Selenium Grid, this is another component that works with Selenium WebDriver. Selenium Grid is for parallel testing, right? Selenium Grid is for parallel testing. If you know language from your computer, if you have three or four other computers, you can write test suite and you can parallelly test on an application. You can parallelly work. Okay, then you can see from the figure Selenium Suite, Selenium IDE, Selenium RC, and Selenium WebDriver merged, and they make it Selenium 2, and then Selenium 3 from Selenium 2, and Selenium Grid. Okay, now what is Selenium IDE that we are going to learn today? Right, we are going to learn Selenium IDE, but what is this Selenium IDE? Hello, who joined?
Good morning, Clive from Bangalore. This is Mavita.
Hey, Dr. Sarabi, thank you for joining. So we are discussing a little bit basics on Selenium IDE. Now, what is Selenium IDE? Now, Selenium IDE means Selenium Integrated Development Environment. It's the simplest framework in Selenium Suite and is the easiest one to learn. See, this is the easiest one to learn. This is the easiest part of Selenium. Rather than any setup, if you want to go further, we will have to do a lot of setup and then we will have to learn a language and then we will be able to start the further. But this IDE is the easiest part. So if you learn it, it is just a beginning of learning. Okay, it is a Firefox plugin that you can install as easily as you can with other plugins. It is a Firefox, see, it just work on Firefox browser. It works as a plugin, right? It works as a plugins. However, because of its simplicity, Selenium IDE should only be used as a prototyping tool. If you want to create more advanced test cases, you will need to use Selenium 2, where you can use WebDriver and Selenium Grid. Now, Selenium WebDriver. The WebDriver proves itself to be better than both Selenium IDE and Selenium RC in many aspects. It implements a more modern, stable approach in automating the browser's actions. WebDriver, unlike Selenium RC, does not rely on JavaScript for automation. It controls the browser by directly communicating with it. So here, WebDriver, Selenium WebDriver, that is the improved version of Selenium IDE and Selenium RC, right? It directly communicates with the browser. And it uses the following, it supports the following language: Java, C Sharp, PHP, Python, Perl, Ruby. It supports multiple languages. Selenium Grid. Selenium Grid is a tool used together with WebDriver, right? Selenium Grid is a separate tool that work with WebDriver to run parallel test across different machines and different browsers all the same time. Parallel execution means running multiple tests at once, right? Selenium Grid is a tool used together with WebDriver to run parallel tests across different machines and different web browsers all the same time. Parallel execution means running multiple tests at once at the same time. Features: enables simultaneous running of tests in multiple browsers and environments using Selenium Grid. Saves time enormously. Utilizes the hub and node concept. The hub acts as a central source of Selenium commands to each node connected to it. In Selenium Grid, one machine is hub and it can communicate with multiple. You can set up multiple machines and this hub will be communicating, you know, with those multiple machines. Okay, now so far with these theories, I want to hear a couple of questions from you, if you have. Do you have any questions so far?
For Selenium, do you use the Selenium to be install it in the VMware or the next machine?
So Selenium, here we are learning IDE, so you can install this IDE anywhere in the Firefox browser.
Okay, but only works in Firefox, that's the only, nothing else, right?
So, as I said, Nafsababi, this is the basic thing that we are going to learn. This is not related to installing, like, if like there are further parts like WebDriver, Selenium WebDriver. If you want to install it, you can install it in your base machine or in a virtual machines. It doesn't matter because it will not expire. All right. Now, install Selenium IDE for Firefox. Now, IDE only works with Firefox, right? So, we are going to install IDE in Firefox browser. I'm also recording this session. I'm going to show you step by step how to set up Selenium IDE in Firefox. Now, to do that, to learn IDE, you will have to have Firefox browser installed in your machine. You will have to have Firefox installed in your machine. Now, can you see if you do not have? I will start from scratch, from the very basic. Can you see if you do not have Firefox? Let me see in my virtual machine if I have Firefox. Let me hold on for a second here. So I'm going to put this URL in a notepad. So to install Selenium IDE, you will have to use Firefox browser, and recommended version of the Firefox browser is Firefox version 47.0.1. So I'm going to download Firefox 47.0.1. Let me show you how I download it. Let me see here what I have over there. So from this 47.0.1 and Linux, Windows 32, Windows 64. Let me see what is this. English, US, okay. Firefox, okay. So from this one, I'm going to download this file. So you saw that, right? How I'm downloading it. I just typed Firefox, download Firefox 47.0.1, and then can you see here this ftp.mozilla.org pub Firefox release 47.0.1. You go there and then you go to Win64 and then English US. Yeah, that is where you are going to click, and then you will get Firefox 47.0.1. Now you can see that I have Firefox installed in my computer. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to remove that Firefox, right? I'm going to remove that Firefox first, and then I'm going to install this older version in my computer. Okay, now how do I remove Firefox, right? Now I'll have to so if you go to your control panel, right? If you go to your control panel, you can go from start menu and then control panel. From there, you have your program features, right? From program features, you go to uninstall and you look for Firefox. You look for your Firefox. If you see this remove, you need to remove only if you already have Firefox installed. If you do not have, if you do not see the icon here in the taskbar, or if you do not see it in the desktop, then you do not need to do that. But if you have already installed Firefox, uninstall it, because we are going to go back to the older version of the Firefox, right? So I'm going to uninstall the existing Firefox that I have. Once that Firefox is gone, I'm done with the uninstall. So I'm done with uninstall of Firefox also. I'm going to remove this maintenance, because that will create issue when you install Firefox. It create issue, so I'm going to remove that maintenance and then close. Now can you see the Firefox downloaded here? I'm going to go to the folder where it downloaded. I'm going to start installing. So I'm going to install that Firefox, and then I'm going to click run, and then I'm going to select some feature. I want you to take a look here. Now here you click next, and then here you click custom instead of standard. In custom, you select this install maintenance. You remove the maintenance service, and then in my start menu and on my desktop, both place I want it. and then use Firefox as my default? No. So you select this option and you do the installation, right? So I did the installation and now I'm launching the Firefox. So once Firefox will be launched here, I'll show you what I'm going to do. Let me first launch it, and once it will be launched, I'm going to show you the next step that you are going to do. Now, if you take a look, Firefox has launched. I'm going to click on Alt T, right? And then you click on Options. In Options, right, if you go to Options by clicking on Alt T, you will get Advanced. In Advanced, you select that, yeah, always use the cursor, warn me, okay. Use smooth, use hardware, check my spelling, use smooth, use. So can you see always use the, can you see this update, right? Never update, never check for update, right? Automatically update search engine, no. I do not want to update anything, I have to keep it 47. Because if you start and if you, you know, it will automatically update. I do not want it. So I'm good at this point, and remember previously I have installed IDE here. So I should see this IDE, Selenium IDE here. So previously I showed you in the okay, let me go through again how you'll be installing IDE. Now if you let me bring that notepad where I have all these links. Let me go to that folder, and in the folder I have this folder, and then Selenium, and inside this one I have the links. So how you gonna install Selenium IDE? So this is where you will get your IDE. So if you go to your Firefox browser and navigate to that URL, right, you will get the IDE. Now here, right, add to Firefox. You just click on add to Firefox, and then this IDE will be added to your Firefox, right? Install and then restart. So now if you Firefox is being restarted, and that's it, your Selenium IDE is got installed. Now when your Selenium IDE is installed, right, you'll see that over there in your developer you will see that Selenium IDE is there, right? Now if you want to do record, right, you do this, and then let's say you do we want to do record on new tools. So click on record, right, and then you go to new tools demo.iot.com, and then you type something, and then put password L12345, automate code run L12345, and click on sign in, right? And then if you come here, let me go to there. Can you see it has recorded the stop? Let me stop recording. So make sure when you are recording, you click it, it will look toggled and you stop recording, right? Now, if you want to play this, make sure you will have to have this URL here in this base URL, right? New tools, how do you bring it? From the browser, you bring this URL here if you want to play it, right? Now, if you have the URL here, if you want to play it, right, you will see your script is doing the operation for you, right? Now if you take a look, you saw that it clicked on login, right? Let me do one more time. Let me play it one more time. So I do not want to never remember password. Okay. Now if you come here and play it, you can see that whatever you recorded. Now if you do not have this URL here, right, then what you will have to do here with target, you will have to provide that URL here, right? Now if you play it again, so here let me put this password. Our user ID is auto mail21 and our password is L12345. Now if you replay it, right, can you see it is going to the URL logging in, right? Now let's say you do not have this URL here, right? You do not have this URL here. So if you play it now, but you do not have it here, you do not have it here, both places. Now if you play it, so it is because we have the base URL here, that's why it is taking us over there. Now let's say you want to click on sign up. So what do you want to do? Click on sign up, right? And then let's say show all available command, and then if you click here, let's say I'm going to say this because I do not have click command over there. So what I did, I just right click and I ask it to wait for this one. Now wait for this one, and then I want to click on it, right? To click on it, you will have to put another command here, let's say click. And where do you want to click? This is the attribute link equal to sign up. So what do you do, you copy this attribute, right, and then you put it here. And also, can you see the value? You copy the value and put it for this, right? Now it will log in, and then it will also log off. Can you see it is logging in, and then it is clicking on sign off, and it was able to sign off. Now can you see it? The run is complete, one passed, no failed. If you want to see the log, that is where you will see the log, right? There is one thing, base URL is not set, update base URL from current window, right? So base URL, you can say this is, you clear this, you will not see this error anymore, right? Now can you see, right? So your script is passing. Now let's say if you provide a incorrect password, right, then it will not be able to find out this sign up, and then it will not be able to click on sign up. So now if you run, right, if you run it, can you see it is here waiting here for sign up, but sign up link is not here because sign up only available if your login is successful. Now can you see here that your script will be failing soon, although it is still waiting for, can you see, wait for test link sign up, it will be waiting a certain amount of time for that sign up link, and then it will throw. Can you see currently executing, can you see timed out after 3000 some amount of time it's saying sign up link is not there. Why? Because we have provided a, can you see, this two step failed and they are orange, nah? So if you put a correct password, okay. Now can you see that test case failed, right? Can you see failure one? Okay. Now if you put the correct password, let's say your correct password is 5, now if you execute it, right, it will not fail anymore. All right. So we have some more details of test case execution. It is in the next step. Your step will be follow these theories, follow this installation of Selenium IDE, and do this couple of test cases that we did in the next video. So, and also I'll be sending you that document that we have reviewed in this class. Thank you for joining. I appreciate your time.